Welcome back to Fish-itis, everyone. We just can't get enough of this. We're calling this walleye opener part two because we didn't get many walleyes on opening day. We only got two. But we're back out. We're going to go to the same spot. Hopefully, the water temperature is a little bit warmer. I'm looking at it right now. It's almost 50 degrees. It was about 46 the last time. Hopefully, we can get some more fish, some fillets today. We've got leeches. We're going to try to slip bobbers and leeches again. We've got some crawlers. Also, throw out some Kaylin's slunker grubs and maybe some tube jigs.
Yeah.
We'll probably get some bass as well. So
yeah.
Come along.
Yeah.
This is too hard to keep our lines out. Oh, this one's gone. This one's gone on a worm. Okay. Sammy, you want this one?
Okay.
Hey, Noah, you have to move, buddy. Okay.
I was right there.
Noah, you have to move up here, Noah.
Okay. Okay.
Move over, Noah. I think this is probably a walleye, guys.
It's a bass.
Yeah, it's a walleye.
Yes!
Wait, oh, okay. Oh, bring him up here.
Walleye.
Yay! All right, Sammy on the worm. Keeper walleye on the orange jig head.
No, he's on eight.
Okay.
He will.
All right, well, first keeper walleye. We've had a bunch of bites. We're trying to get some fillets. That one hit on the orange 32nd ounce jig head tipped with a night crawler. That time a half a night crawler. We've got but get a bunch of bites on leeches. It's a skinny fish, but he'll fillet. Good job,
yeah.
Sammy. Good job reeling him in.
Can I?
You didn't get a bite, buddy.
There's a worm.
Oh, this one's under. Okay. You got him real.
Got him.
All right, good.
Yes.
No, we'll get your line out in a minute. That's under, no. Yeah, you get that one, buddy. No, it's not. It's out there.
Come on. This is a giant.
It's a good walleye.
No, it's a bass.
No, it's a walleye.
Wait, what?
Keep going.
That's a walleye.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Ski 5. Yeah, right. Finally. These fish are hitting, guys. Okay,
that's
so
a
we.
Walleye. I knew that one was going to go under.
All right, so.
Because it looks sort of suspicious because it's like bobbing.
We can't even get our lines out in the water. This is fun right here. That one hit the pink jig head. I think it was the orange last time. I can't remember now. But you know it's on. And you can't even get your lines out there. Whoops. You can't even get all the lines you want to get out.
So,
and we're missing a ton. They're just tough to hook, these walleyes. Some of them are hitting it short. But that one, that was on a leech, I think. I don't even know.
It was on a leech.
That was a leech. Trying so hard to get this hooked on my line, and I can't because the bites.
Got him.
Did you get him? All right. We are on them now, guys. All right, we are on them. Smaller one, but he'll probably keep. Yes! Yeah, it's a good one. Let your bail out. You're reeling it up too far. We are on them, guys. We are on the walleyes. This is what we come out here for. Just good eater male walleyes. Nothing, you know.
No males?
These are all males, yep. Nothing to go crazy about, but fun. For the kids, they're, you know, when you fish in the spring for walleyes, these are all post-spawn fish. And that one doesn't want to let go of the line. They're all post-spawn fish. His teeth are caught in. Look at that. There you go. You know, and they're willing biters. So we've got leeches and night crawlers under slip floats in shallow water. We've got 6-7 feet of water. The bite's on. Good job, Sammy.
Wait, what?
Where is it? Which one's under? This one? It's this one.
No.
Oh, this one's over here.
The white.
Where is it? This one? Wait, no. No, it's this one. There. Yep, no, I think that's a smallmouth. There.
Oh, white smoke.
No, it's a walleye.
Walleye.
Yay, Noni! All right.
It's a walleye.
I don't know. That's a little walleye, but it's I don't know what we had on that.
I think that was a leech. Where somebody gets hit by a gnat.
We couldn't find.
It's a walleye. Walmouth.
Walmouth.
Yeah, walmouth. Did you know that I just got hit by a gnat?
Another gnat.
Again.
Man.
Walmouth. But this time it was on the back of the
tank. We couldn't find it. I could not. Where's the other one? Where's the crawler?
One, two.
One, two. Okay, you sure?
Yep.
All right.
Yeah.
All right. Little walleye, but he'll eat.
Slip float rigs. If you watch Fish-itis, you know we love to slip float fish for a lot of different species, but mostly walleyes. There's a few reasons why slip floats are so effective for walleyes. One is that when you're fishing where there's a lot of structure on the bottom, a lot of wood, a lot of rocks, it's easy to get hung up in that. The walleyes are all around those that stuff. And so a slip float allows you to get it up above the structure so you're not getting snagged up and you can present it to the fish. The other reason is because walleyes suspend a lot. So slip floats are the perfect presentation when they're suspended. A lot of other methods to catch walleyes. Our favorites with slip bobbers, so I'm gonna show you how to rig that up. We like to use 6'6" to 7' medium light action rods. And we just string them up with 8-pound monofilament. We go light for a lot of our species, especially walleyes. So we got the 8-pound mono. We start off with a stopper. I like to use the strings. I've tried the rubber, the plastics. They all kind of get hung up in the reels, and I always end up going back to the strings. They're pretty easy to set up. They come with a tube like this. Put the string through the line through the tube. And then you just pull that off and make sure you pull it the right direction. Some of them have kind of a slot there. It doesn't matter which way you pull it, but for this one, I gotta make sure I pull it toward the end of the line so it comes off. And then you just tighten that on there. There's two strings that you pull. You pull both ends. And what you do is you got some long tags. You got to cut those off. So you just get some clippers and cut those off. Just make sure you leave. Don't cut them too short because you got to pull those snug once you determine what depth you want to fish at. So cut those off like that. And you go ahead and, you can go ahead and cinch them a little bit for now. And then just kind of slide it up the line. So that's your bobber stopper, the string. Next comes a bead. And we've got a bunch of different kinds of beads. The main purpose of the bead, if you can see that, is just to keep the bobber stopper, the string, from getting stuck in the top of the bobber. And I'll show you that in a minute. But so you just put that bead on her and slide it all the way up to the bobber stopper. And you take your fill bobber. I like fills. If you watched, there's a bunch of different kinds, different sizes, different shapes. They have the wobble bobber. This is the tournament series. I like the weighted ones. I can cast them a lot farther. As far as size goes, it just depends on the conditions. If it's a rough water, you're gonna want to go bigger so you can see it. Sometimes it depends on the species. Walleyes, you can go a little bigger with walleyes. If you're fishing for crappies or bluegills, you might want to go a little lighter. Sometimes though, the walleyes too, when they're biting light, you might want to go with the smaller bobber. But basically, you just put that string right through the bobber like that, slide that up. So now you've got the string, the bead, in the float. Next step is a slip sinker. I like to use the egg sinker. I used to use split shots, but they just seem to twist up the line too much. Even with the two-way swivel on there, the line still gets twisted. So I've switched over to a slip sinker. You just put that through, slide that. That goes to the bobber. So now we've got our string, our bead, our bobber, and our slip sinker end of the line. go with a two-way swivel. Now, I already went and tied it on, so I'm not wasting time here trying to tie in front of the camera, but so I've got my leader, and this is fluorocarbon. I like to use Saguar, 8 pound usually, sometimes 6, sometimes 10, depends on the walleyes. If they're not hitting, I'll go lighter. But basically, you've got your two-way swivel, and you tie that to the main line. And I'll go ahead and tie this one. I tie a clinch knot. Been tying them like that. Clinch knot since I was a little boy. And I can tie them pretty fast. So I know there's a bunch of other good knots out there. The polymer's a good one. I just never bothered to learn it because I've used a clinch knot all my life. So I tied that on there. So I've got my fluorocarbon leader. That's a little bit short. I usually like to go a little longer than that. But on the end of that, we've got your hook or your jig head. And we like to use mostly 32nd ounce. Sometimes go a little heavier. It's fine. Depends on the conditions, again. But we have a variety of colors we use. Pink's a really good one. Chartreuse is hot. Orange. Experiment. Switch up. These walleyes are really picky. Just changing color sometimes can trigger a bite. It's just amazing. They can be really something else, these walleyes. That's why I guess they're so much fun to try and catch. But anyway, you've got your jig head, so then we'll go ahead and tip a leech. You've seen us using leeches. Sometimes a half of a crawler. We'll put that on hook that onto the jig head. And some days they'll just hit the crawler. Some days just the leeches, so you got to switch it around. We've even put minnows on here, and we've caught walleye. So, but that's basically our presentation. So we've got, again, bobber stopper, bead, float, slip sinker, two-way swivel, and then your hook or your jig head. It's a lot of steps, but extremely productive way to catch not only walleyes, but all species of fish.